Hey guys, I'm Deepthi Desikan, and in today's video, as you guys saw by the title, is a full face of Sugar Cosmetics. So some of this were new launches that were sent to me by the brand, and some of this was purchased by me, as you guys saw in my haul video. So I pretty much have almost all the products in each category, but just mascara I don't have. And also something that is going to be super exciting for you guys, as part of their new launch, which is the Sugar Grand Finale Setting Mist, which I have right here, which I will be talking about in detail in this video. So there's going to be a giveaway in this video. So there are going to be two winners. All the details, everything will be in the description box below. Also watch till the end so that you guys can have an idea about these setting mists. So yeah, so there are also a couple of other new launches from them, which I have demoed in this video. So everything you would need will be right here. So let's get to the video. So firstly, I will be starting off with my brows, and today I'm going to be using their newest launch, which is their Arch Arrival 3-in-1 Brow Shaper. Now I'm going to be using the shade Jelly Brown, but they also have another shade called Taupe Tom, which is a slightly grayish shade. So if you like those kind of shades on yourself, you can use it, but Jelly Brown works pretty well for my brows, and I'm going to be like just lining it in the shape of my brows, not overlining anything of that sort, because I don't really like very thick brows on myself. So what I really like about this brow pencil is something that I've already tried, okay? One side you get the product where you fill in your brows. The other side you have this sponge tip applicator where you get this eyebrow powder that you can fill in your brows, and you get a spoolie as well. So everything that you would actually need, you have right here. So firstly, I'm going to be just like brushing the hair in the way that I want to probably fill in the brows. And then I'm going to be taking the shade Jelly Brown, like I mentioned, and going to be filling it in the direction of the hair. So usually you've not seen any tutorial of mine where I've actually shown you guys a brow product demonstration, because it's very difficult for me. I need to get really close to the mirror. But with this, you guys can see I'm just using one hand, not that close to a mirror, and I'm recording myself doing it. Now moving on to the sponge tip side, you have to be very careful, or you can squish the product in like I did. Like I was really harsh with it and I kind of squished the product in, but you can still manage to use the sponge tip applicator. And anywhere where you couldn't get the product that much, you can use it. Now another new launch of theirs, which was sent to me recently, is the Arch Arrival Brow Powder that goes in complement to the eyebrow pencil. So in this as well, I'm going to be using the shade Jelly Brown. This is for everyone who wants to set their eyebrow hair in place. This would be really handy if you want something on the go. You don't have the time to precisely line your brows. Just look at that. It's so easy to actually fill in your brows with this itself. Now once we're done with the eyebrows, I'm going to be moving on to the eyeshadow. Now for eyeshadow, I'm going to be using this eyeshadow palette. This is the Blend the Rules eyeshadow palette in the shade 02 Warrior. Now firstly, as a quick transition shade, I'm going to be using this one right here. And then for my outer corner, I'm going to be using this shade. I have already tried this palette out. I really like the pigmentation of the matte shades. They blend really well and they're really smooth. They are not patchy. They don't skip or anything of that sort, like you guys can see. And then just to sort of darken the outer corner a little bit, I'm going to be using this black shade right here. This is actually a very pigmented black shade, and you can like intensify it according to however you like. For the shimmer shade, I'm going to be taking this shade. As you guys can see, I'm just applying it with my fingers. And then they apply just so beautifully. And then now for some kajal, I'm going to be using this one. This is the Kohl of Honor Intense Kajal in the shade Blackout. So I'm going to be leaving the eyes at this. I don't have a mascara from Sugar, so I'm going to be doing that off camera later. But let's move on to the face makeup. So now let's prep the face for some makeup, shall we? The first one I'm going to be using is the Sugar Aquaholic Priming Moisturizer. They have a lot of different primers, something that you can try out, but I wanted something that can cater to my skin type and something that I can use in future videos as well. I just didn't want to buy anything that is like, okay, trendy, their stick primers or anything of the sort, because I am not a stick primer person. I need the usual primer form. So I'm going to be using this one. This is very nice and thick, like a balm kind of a texture. Smells refreshing. I just love the feel of this. It looks like I found a dupe for a very popular primer, which will be coming up in my full face of makeup dupes video. Now, just for the sake of this video, you don't have to use these many products, because I have all these products in hand, I just want to give it a good try. So I'm going to be also prepping my skin with their Blink Illuminating Moisturizer. This is in the shade Peach Poppin. I want to see if it is like the strobe cream. Just a little bit of glow to my skin if it adds any. Now, if you are like me, where you like to use a good highlighting mist or something a little more dewy on the skin before you start off with your makeup, like they have three setting mist options. So they have a dewy mist, highlighting setting mist, and a matte mist that has been recently launched. And this is what the packaging of the product looks like. Now, you can use this before your foundation, after your foundation. So just for my base, I'm going to be using this highlighting mist just to see how it works and if it actually does add any highlighting effect to the skin. It is quite highlighting, like you guys can see, it adds a little bit of shine but not glitter particles on your face. It's almost like a strobe cream in a liquid form. So now that our base is nice and set, let's move on to a little bit of color correction. So I'm going to be using their Face Forward Blush Stick. Now this is in the shade Coral Climax. So this is a nice coral shade, and I'm going to be using it with my finger because I don't want to take a lot of product. So a little is enough for my kind of color correction. So this shade, you can use it as a blush shade or as a color corrector. So then for foundation, I'm going to be using one of my favorite stick foundations. This is the Sugar Ace of Face Stick Foundation. I got this one in the shade 03 Chococino. You guys have heard me talk about this quite a few times. I have used it on some special occasions as well. It does have a little bit of flashback, so just be aware of that. But it gives really good coverage. It's creamy, doesn't cling on to any dry patches on the skin, nothing. I usually do use the brush that comes with the foundation itself. You can of course use any other brush if this is like too time consuming. It just stipples the product in pretty well. There are no brush streaks. Just look at the way it looks like skin, but with good coverage, like smooth on the skin, not emphasizing any texture. And then moving on to concealer, I got their Magic Wand Waterproof Concealer, and this is in the shade 30 Chococino. I got the shade that is corresponding to the foundation. I was actually looking to buy the shade up because I like my concealers to match my skin tone to the dot, but all of it was sold out because of Nykaa's sale, so I just got whatever was left. It's beautiful, it's blending really well, and it's kind of creamy underneath the eyes as well, and it's not caking up and giving me pretty good coverage. Like you guys saw how pigmented the color corrector was, and it just concealed it really well, and I didn't even use that much of product. Now moving on to setting the concealer in place, I'm going to be using this All Set to Go translucent powder. They have a banana powder and all that, but all of that was out of stock, so I got the translucent powder. I'm usually not quite big on translucent powders because I feel like they do have a little bit of white cast in pictures. So I usually prefer banana powder for my skin tone. So it does come with a sponge like this, and all you have to do is like just press it. So I'm going to be using my brush. Now if you are someone who likes to bake, you can. I don't really have the need to bake, so I'm not big into baking. So I just use the powder very, very sparingly. That powder is pretty fine. It set the concealer in place and kind of like mattified that place as well. And then moving on to bronzer, blush and all that good stuff, I'm going to be using this palette. This is their contour, their Force palette in the number 02. It has a blush, bronzer and a highlighter shade. So I'm going to take the bronzer just to my forehead. I don't really like to bronze my face, because it makes my face look a little more slimmer than it already is. So I already have a pretty skinny face. And then for blush, I'm going to be taking this shade. I like to go a little overboard with the blush. And so if you're like, okay, that is a lot of blush, by the end of this video, you'll notice that there's going to be no blush remaining. So that's the reason I go a little overboard with the blush. And this is really smooth on the skin. It doesn't emphasize anything, so I can get away with that. Now for highlighter, I'm going to be using my favorite highlighter. This is the Face Forward Stick highlighter. This is in the shade Bronzed Bellwether. This is one of my favorite highlighters. You guys know I've talked about this so many times. It's so smooth but yet wet looking. It still shows up really well, not too intense, not too subtle. So So if you want something that looks very natural on the skin, so easy to blend. If you're of course going to just leave it like that, that's going to be a stripe on your skin, but you need to blend it a little bit into your skin, and it's very easy to blend, and there's not like visible shimmer particles on your skin. You can't even see it. It's just like a wet look. You can use it even on daily basis for a natural look. So now what I'm going to be doing is setting my face with their Grand Finale Dewy Setting Mist. The smell on this is so nostalgic. I'm not very sure what it's reminding me of. It's a very like very familiar smell. And I just really like it actually. And just taking a sponge and sort of meshing all the products in together. This is my favorite step. I do it all the time. So the setting mist actually takes off any sort of powderiness on my skin. It's a nice small packaging and you get 50 ml of product in this. So while your skin is a little bit wet, you can of course use a little bit of powder highlighter and top the highlighter off just on the high point. Now I'm going to be finishing off with the lips. I'm going to be using their Matte as Hell crayon lipstick. This is in the shade 35. So easy to actually line your lips as well. Just look at the pigmentation of that. So yeah, that's pretty much it. This is a full face of Sugar products. There's not like one product I can actually complain about. There's not one product that actually didn't work for me. Everything in the video that I tried out was amazing. I'm so glad I actually bought some of these products to make this video, even though the brand sent me quite a few of it, because I just wanted it to be a wholesome video, something that is like complete. And I just love the products that I've tried out today. There's not one miss. Don't forget to participate in the giveaway. There will be two winners that will be picked by me and will be announced on the Sugar Instagram page. Make sure you follow all the rules, like subscribing to my YouTube channel and Sugar's YouTube channel, and also to my Instagram page and Sugar Instagram page. So all the rules, just in case you guys don't miss out on anything, will be given in the description box below. So yeah, good luck to you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also hit that notification bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye. Yeah, baby.